Welcome to this tutorial, Writing a Research Question, Do's and Don'ts for the Argument Essay with Sources Project. You're probably asking yourself, why do we need to write a research question before we start? And there are some specific answers to that. The first is, having a research question focuses your thoughts. Instead of just doing research on tattoos, if you have a question that says, what are the medical benefits of tattoo removal? Now you're not going to get articles on the history of tattoos or how they're status symbols for some cultures. You're only going to be looking at the medical benefits. Another reason why you might write a research question is that it defines the scope. When you're looking at a topic, chances are there's going to be a lot of information about it. You want to make sure that you are looking at a specific part of that information and not everything. Especially with a short research paper that we're writing, you want to make sure that you are really on point. And finally, it's going to provide a roadmap for you. If you know the things that you need to find, it's going to make your research much easier and less daunting when you get a whole bunch of results. So let's take a look at the don'ts. Don't ask a question that can be answered yes or no. When we do research questions, we're assuming that there are a lot of different answers to the question. Just as there are gray areas in life, there are gray areas in research. This question, is Rick Grimes a psychopath, is only going to look for the answer yes or no. It's not going to allow us to look at any other idea that may be associated with Rick Grimes, or we may go into it with a bias. Yes, he is, so you only look at research that says these are the things that a psychopath has. This is what Rick Grimes has. Remember, you also have to think of that refutation that's going to be part of the four pillars. You also don't want to be vague. There has to be that clear roadmap. Are the characters in The Walking Dead normal? Well, normal is a really vague term. Not easy to define. And there's a lot of characters in there. Some are no longer with us, and some have been there from the beginning. But this is a vague question because I haven't gotten it down to that laser focus yet. And finally, don't choose the obvious. Does Sheldon Cooper have an eidetic memory? Well, he says it over and over in the show. There's no need to write a paper about it if that has already been proven. Is Harry Potter a wizard? Okay, I think we all know the answer to that. So you want to make sure that you don't just go with the obvious answer. So let's take a look at the do's. Do ask an open-ended question. Ways that you get that is how? What? Those are the types of words that are going to bring in multiple answers. Do have a defined scope. You can't write about the whole history of something or the entire idea of something. Remember, you have to narrow it down to what can be managed in a short research essay. You need to include both the primary source and the secondary lens. Remember that primary source is what you're writing about, the television show, the character, the novel, whatever it is that you've chosen as your primary source, and the secondary lens is the way that you're looking at it. Are you looking at it like a psychologist would look at it? Are you looking at it through economics? How are you going to be examining this primary source? So let's look at some examples. In what way does the character Dean Winchester exemplify Joseph Campbell's hero's journey? Our primary source, Dean Winchester in the show Supernatural. Our secondary lens, we're going to be doing our research on Joseph Campbell's hero's journey and applying it to Dean Winchester in the show. How does the film Dawn of the Dead reflect consumption economics? Again, the primary source is the film Dawn of the Dead. The secondary lens is consumption economics, which means my research is going to be on consumption economics, and I'm going to apply those ideas to the film Dawn of the Dead. What symptoms of PTSD, if any, can be seen in the character Rick Grimes? Rick Grimes is our primary source. PTSD is our secondary lens. But notice how I left it open there. What if in the course of my research on PTSD, I find that he doesn't have it? Well, that can be an argument too. And finally, how does the film Bridesmaids portray female empowerment? So, Bridesmaids, primary source. My research, my secondary lens, is on female empowerment. I learn everything I can about that, and then I analyze the film using that secondary lens. So if you keep these ideas in mind as you craft that research question, it is going to make your research simpler in the end. So if you're still unsure, two tips for you. Review the course materials. Much of this you're going to find in the instructions for the assignment, in the videos that you've watched. So, I'm trying to make it as easy as possible for you. But if you're still unsure, ask for help before you get behind. I'm just an email away. Please use me as a source. If you need to email me, you can either do it through Canvas or you can email me at lrosen@coastline.edu. Well, good luck. I look forward to seeing your research questions.